give a very short answer. There are three worldviews regarding what happens to us after we die. First is the atheistic worldview, which most humanists will subscribe to, which says that you get snuffed out, Mr. Lakhani, nothing remains. Don't you notice? You get snuffed out and you can be cremated and boom, you're just, you know, dust is gone. This is one view. There's nothing is left. It gets snuffed out. All this me and my individuality, my intellect, all gets snuffed out. This is one view. The second view is, if like from the Abrahamic tradition, which means Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, they talk about this life and the next everlasting life. It doesn't stop at all. It goes on for infinite years. And either if you're a goody-goody, you go to heaven and have fun with God forever and ever. And if you're a baddie-baddie, oh dear, you are then roasted forever and ever in hell. Now, this is the Abrahamic vision. I think the reason why they brought this in is simply to keep their devotees in line, make sure they don't sit on the fence. That's, oh, you must be devout, otherwise we go to hell forever. And this is horrible. I mean, how can God send anybody to eternal hell, however bad the person is? So anyway, this is the Abrahamic vision. The third vision we have from the Indic religions, which is Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, and Sikhism, is the idea of reincarnation. The Buddhists call it by a different name called rebirth. The idea that the thing that is living here, the mental mood that I possess, doesn't get snuffed out when I die. It tries to find re-expression in another body. So it looks for another, if you like, there is a period of rest, and then after the rest, that individual is reborn again, you know, as most probably as a human being, and continues his spiritual progress from where he left off. And the character is chiseled in one life is the only thing that comes with him from this life to the next life. And this is how his law of karma catches up, because he's chiseled his character. That character will give him certain qualities in his next life. That's why he gets his benefit of the work he put in this life in his next life. This is the idea of reincarnation. This goes on. If it goes on forever, it'll be like a prison. It comes to a halt when you recognize, oh dear, actually, I don't need to be born. I am the spirit. And when you don't believe in it, just experience it. Then the cycle of reincarnation stops, and that's called moksha, end of delusion. I don't need to be chasing after chocolate cakes anymore. I've done it.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism, sponsored by People Care. Encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.